Hi friends, welcome to my channel Kitchen to Kitchen. Today I'm going to share with you 5 unique raita recipes that are very easy to make and are extremely healthy. If you enjoyed today's video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, share and comment. Let's get right into it. First is a pink raita, and for that I'm going to use some carrots, and I have grated them, some grated beetroot and some grated radish. The total of these vegetables is about a cup, and one chili. Some salt to taste. Next I'm using some roasted cumin seeds, and I have crushed them in mortar and pestle, about 2 teaspoons, 1 teaspoon of sugar, and give everything a really good mix for a few seconds. Always beat the yogurt that you use for your raita. This makes it really nice and smooth, and if you want it a little bit runny, you can also add some water. So I've added a total of about 3 big spoons, and you can, you know, increase or decrease per your taste, but this was good for the amount of vegetables that I'm using. Take it out in a serving bowl. Now I'm going to heat up the tadka pan and add about 2 teaspoons of cooking oil. Once the oil is hot, add 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds, and as they start to crackle, switch off the flame and add some hing. The tadka is now ready. Let's pour it over the raita. The second one is the potato raita. In a bowl, add about 1 big boiled potato, and I've chopped it into small pieces. 1 teaspoon of roasted cumin seeds, salt to taste, 2 teaspoons of red chili powder, and you can decrease the amount if you like it less spicy. Give everything a really good mix for a few seconds. Next up, add the yogurt. Mix it well for a few seconds. Let's take it out in a serving bowl. Potato raita is now ready. The third one is the pepper raita. In a pan, add about 3 teaspoons of oil. Flame is on medium high. Once the oil is hot, add 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, and as they crackle, add some hing, 1 green chili, some curry leaves, about 1 to 2 strings, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, and to this tempering now add 1 cup of chopped bell peppers. I'm using colored ones, so some yellow, red and orange bell peppers. Now add some salt. Give everything a really good mix. Cook the bell peppers on a medium-high flame for about 3 to 5 minutes. The bell peppers have really gotten that nice flavor. We are not necessarily cooking them through, so they are still crunchy. Add the sauteed bell peppers to a bowl. To this, now add about 3 big spoons of yogurt. And again, you can, you know, add or decrease as you like it. Give everything a really good mix. It out in a serving bowl. Pepper raita is now ready. The fourth one is the onions, tomatoes and cucumber raita. In a bowl, add about 1/4 cup of chopped onions, and I'm using white ones which are a little sweeter, 1/4 cup of chopped tomatoes and 1/4 cup of cucumber. I've peeled it and then chopped it into small pieces. Some coriander leaves, salt to taste, and 1 teaspoon of sugar. Give everything a really good mix. To this, now add about 3 big spoons of yogurt. Mix it really well. The onions, tomatoes and cucumber raita is now ready. Let's serve it. The fifth one is the eggplant raita or the Baigan raita. Add 3 teaspoons of oil to the pan. The flame is on the medium high. To spread the oil through the pan like this, add 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds, some hing, and I'm just spreading it through the pan like this. Next, add the eggplants, and I have chopped them into semicircle shape like this. Now we are going to sprinkle some red chili powder. Sprinkle some salt. After cooking for about 1 to 2 minutes, flip them. Sprinkle some red chili powder and salt on the other side too. Give it a toss like this. Cook it on the other side for 1 or 2 minutes. The eggplants are really become nice and soft and are ready. We are not necessarily cooking them through. They have shrinked a bit and that's good enough. Switch off the flame and take them out in a bowl. To this, now add 3 big spoons of yogurt. Give everything a really good mix. Serve it in a bowl. Enjoy the Baigan Raita. Now that you've seen all 5 recipes of Raita, do give it a try next time you make a paratha, biryani, or as a side dish with your meal. I'm confident that you'll love them. These are super delicious and very healthy. If you've enjoyed today's video, please don't forget to share your valuable feedback. Have a great day.